Thank you. Thank you very much for coming, and thank you for the applause. So that piece, it may need some explanation. I was going to say it at the beginning, but I wanted to talk a little bit more between these two pieces because it's a lot of notes. So that first piece was by Samantha Hogan. She is a composer based out of the Twin Cities up in Minnesota. This is her quote, "fueled by coffee, compassion, and a combustible imagination. Her music is influenced by a variety of styles from classical rock, jazz, and video game music. And her works encompass chamber, solo, multimedia, and large ensemble pieces." That particular piece, this is also a quote from her, because I could not say it any other way. This is her speaking. "Throughout my time at YSU, I've visited Mill Creek several times. This concerto is a reverie of those adventures and misadventures in the park. Movement one was inspired by the beauty and mystery of the trees and the illegible writing that adorns the bark from past lovers and general graffiti artists." So, does that make more sense now? "The second movement is a scherzo of sorts, reminiscent of those pesky geese that gathered around and plotted evil while Beau and I would just play duets under the tree by the lily pond. They would stare at us with their malicious glare and listen while we blissfully ignored them. Sometimes they would even march in time an inch near us, those honking devils. When spring comes, the snow melts and there is a thunderous roar as an increased volume of water gushes past the mill. Eventually, this runoff is tamed as it reaches the Mahoning River, and beauty and tranquility is once again restored as summer returns in that last third movement." So, as you can tell, there's lots of stuff going on, lots of visuals for you. So. I toyed around with saying it before, but there we go. All right, so this next piece, it's Wind Tides. It's by Adrian Albert. She is an LA-based composer who has had her works performed all over the world and has been recorded on many major labels. Wind Tides was commissioned by the trombonist Andy Malloy. He made a double CD of trombone works with this one, and he commissioned and called Paperclips. So she entered this piece in the trombone competition at Wright State University several years back, and lo and behold, it won. On that particular performance, Megumi Kanda, could be pronounced her name wrong, but she played it there, and then she also played it at the International Trombone Festival in the Redlands. So this is Wind Tides by Adrian Albert.
Thank you.
Sorry for the awkward silence there. This next piece is by Evan Williams. I came across Evan Williams when I was trying to program for my group Durward Ensemble, which will be here next week at 7:30 next Thursday, if you want to come for that. He's an African-American composer. He is he teaches at Rhodes College, and this work was commissioned by Vento Trio, metalwork. So the first movement is iron. I guess I'm saying that right. The symbol is Fe. It's a hard metal that was proved important throughout history in construction and warfare. It is also an essential element in the proper function of the body's blood cells. The second movement is alloys, which is also in a passacaglia. So metals were created by a mixture, fusion, blend of multiple metallic elements. The result is a stronger or less corrosive metal than the sum of its parts. And then the last is steel, an alloy in which iron is the primary element. It is especially important in the construction of commercial buildings. So here is Metalwork by Evan Williams. Thank you.
Thank you.
this last piece is by Nicole Chamberlain. She's kind of have a, she has an interesting story. She started her career as a web and graphic designer, and then at the age of 32 decided to follow her dream and to compose and play flute for a living. So now she has many works, and she has a huge presence in the flute world. This piece, Whale, it was the winner. I'm trying to get this situated here. It was the winner of the National Flute Association's 2017 newly published music competition in the Chamber Works for Flute and Other Instruments category. Whale was commissioned by flutist Dr. Shelley Martinson to perform with her husband, trombonist Philip Martinson. The work is separated into three movements, allowing each player to play out and exhibit the possibilities available on each instrument and displaying similarities between two completely different instruments. So we are performing movement one and two. The first is Rusty Gate, and which is slang for someone who can't swing. So there's that. And then the second movement is Noir. It's inspired by the film scores found in the film noir movement in the 1940s and 1950s. So here is the two movements of Whale.
Thank you.
DJ Gustafson over here.
There's a few beatboxing techniques. That's pretty fun. One doesn't get to do that classical concert very often. And we've got a flute pizzicato here with the tongue, and also some vocalization as well as the ch sound. And the big welcome back, that's a jet whistle. Just kind of it's a primer in extended flute techniques. And for that, we're very grateful to Nicole. It's really fun to play this piece.
Ha 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 ha